It's a laser system and it's very fast. It just picks up data like instantly. All right, guys, we're here today and we're gonna unbox the new HX2 3D scanner from Shining 3D. Now, this is the blue laser scanner that changed the game back in 2019 or so. It was one of the first blue laser scanners at an affordable price on the market, and it really made scanning a lot better, faster, more portable, and it picked up a lot more data than all the previous scanners. That being said, this is the HX2, and not a lot has changed, but we're gonna show you everything inside when you buy it from visualminer.com. That being said, we do consult and do demos, live video demos, or even scan stuff for you to see how it's gonna work before you actually buy. So give us a call, shoot us an email if you're in the market for one of these units. We've also got the free scans and all the other types of scanners out there, depending what you're doing. So hit us up, we're here to help. That being said, let's see what's inside this box and what has changed. So let's dive right in. Okay. As usual, they do pack them in very thick cardboard boxes, and then we've got the hard case. This is a Pelican-style travel case, and it's actually got wheels on it here, which is really nice. So you can see it's got the full wheels. It's even got this handle that you can press this lever down and pull the handle up, so you can just take this around like a carry-on bag, and you could probably throw this at a wall and it'd be just fine. So very good, very sturdy, very well built. Let's check out what's on the inside. Okay, first things first, you've got the thank you for choosing the Einscan 3D scanner and the components, the packing list of what's inside, always good. The calibration certificate, also always good. And then everything is looking pretty standard. You've got the USB, which should have some software and a user manual and a quick start guide on it. And then you've got a bunch of markers. This should be about 3,000 markers if I recall correctly, actually. So it's a lot of markers. You get more than enough as needed to do multiple scan projects. You could probably do a couple cars, full cars in laser mode with this many markers. Over on the right here, we've actually got a little adapters. Now these will let you change out the power block to fit into any worldwide outlet. So this can really be traveled with and taken around anywhere you want to plug into standard or non-standard outlets. Very cool. And of course, the power block itself. Now this is a little bit different because it is actually going to be a full plug and play. This is pretty cool. This is a totally new power block. This is actually very different. Looks like we are still running at 3 amps, 36 watts, 12 volts. We're gonna be using this one right here. Very good, okay. On this side, you've got the power cable. Nicely coiled and fitting right in there. You've got your power cable. Now this is the power and data. So you plug this end in to USB 3 or greater. And then you've got this USB on the end, which plugs into the scanner. And then this is the power that plugs into the scanner. Now this power block plugs into this cable right here. And that allows it to send power and data through the same cable. Next, we've got these cable clips. Now these are really, really handy for securing the cable to your desk or something in the area while you're scanning so that if you trip or if you're, you know, pulling the cable far away from your workstation, then these will keep the cable secured into the computer. So just a good safety thing. They started including these a few years ago. I like that. And of course, the scanner itself. Let's check it out. Pop in here. The scanner itself looks almost identical. You can tell, obviously, the logo on the back. Personally, I noticed a little bit different finish on some of the black plastic, like they used a slightly different material. The injection molded buttons on the back look a little bit different, a little more refined. And overall, the front's similar, but there is less glass on the bottom here. And then both of these are coated in like a gold sort of coating. So we've got that. Let's see what else we've got in here underneath. And of course you have the calibration board. Now this one's a little bit different than you see on the Freescan combo. It's a larger board. So we'll go ahead and set this to the side real quick. Okay, so there you go. Now the way you actually use this calibration board is that this is actually a jig. So I'm gonna put this down on the table and then I'm going to open up the calibration board. I'm gonna orient these little rectangles towards the bottom and line it up on the jig. And there we are. And then within the software, you go through and you calibrate right there using this whole board. Very nice. Now I do also like to keep this in the plastic. You can see this outer side of it is actually white, and that's used to calibrate the white balance when you're scanning in full color and also for calibrating the lasers. Now it doesn't really matter too much keeping it clean. Frankly, on our old demo unit of the HX, after a few years, there was a lot of little fingerprints and everything like that, but it didn't affect the calibration. So it's really just having something solid and white for the scanner to look at. Go ahead and put this away. All right, so what I really like about this, honestly, is that the case allows everything to stay in one place with the scanner, and it makes it really easy to lug it around, and you know it's safe and protected. So very, very good setup here from Shining 3D. And of course, when you buy it on visionminer.com, we do include our scanner pyramids and usually another special gift like a can of A-Sub or something like that, which is a disappearing scanning spray. So that being said, this is everything you really need other than a powerful computer to run this scanner, but there's also accessories and other little things that come in handy, like the scanning pyramids that we make and give away with the scanner. We also sell them if you want some of those. All right, we're gonna get this away and let's talk about what's different. What did they change? This looks almost identical to the original, but what's different? There's gotta be something changed, right? Yes, there is, but it's not much. I will say they really didn't change a whole lot. The actual difference on paper, other than this power block right here, is they've made it faster. So as we've seen with the Freescan combos, it's a laser system and it's very fast. It just picks up data like instantly, it feels like. Whereas the HX then, with the update of the combo, seemed a little slow, a little clunky, a little behind, right? It still worked well, but it wasn't as fast and snappy. So now, with the HX2, you get that same performance. You get 120 frames per second and about 3 times the data capture. So I believe it's now at 1.6 million something points per second, whereas the old one was somewhere in the 400,000 points per second that would gather. So it's over 3x faster than the original HX. That is the only difference. So of course you've got the different windows on the front of the units, they're slightly changed, but overall, really, they've just come in and updated the unit to be a little more modern and faster with the scanning. So the performance is up there. So if you're on a budget and you need the blue lasers, this is gonna be the scanner to buy. Now, that being said, it's the new version. What's the new price? Well, it's exactly the same price. But with that, they've actually changed up some of the software bundles. So while the scanner's coming in around the same price, about 10 grand with everything you see here, these software packages have changed. They actually partnered with a company, and ExModel is the new software to replace the Geomagic Essentials software in the previous red bundles. Now you have the ExModel bundle, and that is a fantastic software for reverse engineering. Not so much inspection and metrology, but reverse engineering, turning your scan into a CAD file, taking your surfaces and making a parametric design out of it. We've had a lot of people use it actually specifically for making two-dimensional cutouts, like DXF files that go in a laser cutter to make upholstery or floor mats or vinyl cuts, vinyl wrap cuts and things like that, directly from the scan. And I will say it's much faster and much easier than Geomagic ever was at that particular application. And it also seems pretty straightforward and much more just designed to turn your part into CAD, whereas Geomagic was a much more full-fledged software suite that could do anything with scan data. ExModel is really focused in on turning your scan into a parametric CAD design to make your lives easier. So that being said, Not that much has changed. It's the same price, it's a lot faster, and we'll have a couple videos coming out to show you how fast and how well it scans and everything else. But for the most part, you can pretty much reference the old HX videos if you want to know what the scanning experience is going to be like. Got a lot of different videos scanning a lot of different things, but what would you scan if you had this scanner? Maybe we'll just turn that idea into a video. All right, guys, thank you so much for watching. If you need help or you need assistance in picking what 3D scanner to buy for your project, or maybe you're looking at a 3D printer, we sell those too. We specialize in industrial grade engineering thermoplastics like PEEK and Ultim and PPSU and many, many, many more. So whether it's scanning, reverse engineering, or printing, we're here to help you with your business, picking the right equipment, but being sure of your purchase. So give us a call, shoot us an email. We're always here to help. And with that, have a positive rest of your day. I'll see you on the next video.